In this screencast, we're going to take a look at both Scratch files and Scratch buffers and identify their key uses. Scratch files and buffers are useful for a range of things, including string snippets, commands you want to run, to-do lists, or perhaps trying out some code in isolation. Scratch files and Scratch buffers are temporary files that are available across your projects in IntelliJ IDEA. We can view them in our Scratches and Consoles folder in the project window, and if you create them in one project, they'll appear in your other projects in the same location, providing you're using the same version of IntelliJ IDEA. Scratch files and buffers are temporary files, but they will persist when you restart IntelliJ IDEA, even if you invalidate your caches. However, they will be removed if you restore your default settings or reinstall IntelliJ IDEA. Let's take a look at Scratch files first. We can use Command, Shift and N on macOS or Ctrl, Alt, Shift and Insert on Windows and Linux to make a new Scratch file. This is a list of all the Scratch file types that we can create. These files are all IDE aware. We can start typing in the file type that we're looking for example Kotlin, and then we can create our code using the normal IDE functionality that we'd expect, including running it. We can also change the language of a Scratch file. For example, we can change this text file to HTML by right-clicking on it and selecting Change Language. We can start typing in HTML to filter the list, and when we press Return, IntelliJ IDEA will render the contents correctly. We can move Scratch files into our project as well. You can do this using drag and drop or by pressing F6 to refactor the file. Once a Scratch file is part of a specific project, it will not be visible in the Scratch files directory in this project or any other. We recommend you rename your Scratch files to something that's more meaningful for you. For example, we can refactor this Java Scratch file to be Hello Java, and I'll go ahead and rename scratch.md as I know that's a markdown template for Java Annotated Monthly. Scratch buffers are always text files, but they're an alternative to Scratch files. There's not a keyboard shortcut for creating a Scratch buffer, but you can create one quickly using Shift Command and A on macOS or Shift Control and A on Windows and Linux, and then start typing in Scratch. Scratch buffers are useful for any quick notes that you want to make. These might be snippets of code or other useful strings. Scratch buffers in IntelliJ IDEA use a default naming convention. The first Scratch buffer that you create is called buffer1.txt. The second will be called buffer2.txt, and so forth up to buffer5.txt. This is the maximum number that we can have. If we try and create more, IntelliJ IDEA will prompt us and overwrite the contents of the first Scratch buffer that we created. We can rename our Scratch buffers to something more meaningful, and then they won't count towards our allowance of 5. For example, we can rename buffer2.txt to database-connection.txt. When we create another Scratch buffer this time around, we get a blank buffer2.txt because we renamed the previous one. We can also change the language of Scratch buffers to benefit from the IDE-aware functionality. For example, we can type some groovy code into our buffer2.txt file, but we won't get any IDE help because it's currently still a text file. We can fix that by right-clicking on buffer2.txt and selecting Change Language. When we select Groovy and press Return, we can see that IntelliJ IDEA renders the file accordingly. Both Scratch files and buffers are treated in a similar way to other files in IntelliJ IDEA. We can use Shift Command and E on macOS or Control Shift and E on Windows and Linux to see them in our recent locations. We can filter this dialog by changed locations too. Even though Scratch files and buffers are not in source control, IntelliJ IDEA still tracks their changes locally, and you can view this in your local history. Both Scratch files and Scratch buffers help you to reduce clutter in your main project, whilst keeping you focused on your current task. However, they are temporary files, so please treat them as such. Check anything important into version control if you want to keep hold of it. Thanks for watching.